Okay, now the 1987 constitution provides three modes to change the charter. People's initiative is one of them.
Yes.
Why, just to balance the conversation, why are many fearful of this people's initiative when it is provided for by law?
Well, we're not actually fearful of the mode of people's initiative. In fact, only the Philippines has that kind of mode. I lecture in MCLEs, and I've studied some jurisdictions, and there is no such similar, amending the constitution through a people's initiative. There are some in the US, but it's amending a federal law. It's the constitution. So yeah, it's good to give the people a chance to exercise their right to change the constitution. The problem with any of this mode is not actually the mode, because for me, constitutional reform is necessary. You want to change the constitution for the better, that's good. The problem always of Bayan Muna here is kinakargahan nilang cha-cha. They always load it with their personal agenda and vested interest. They always say, Neri, here you are. You're going to oppose again. Here you're proposing again. That's why we're opposing. Don't load your cha-cha with your term extension. Don't load your cha-cha with your, creation of whatever parliamentary that
okay.
you want.
All right. So, now, I won't go as far as parliamentary, but let me just be contrarian here. I mean, yeah. I'm not saying I'm pro or anti anything. Yeah. But sometimes a challenging discussion benefits us all. Yes. Aren't the terms too short? In the U.S., you have the president 4-4. In the U.S., you don't have term limits. That's the argument they're using. What are your thoughts? Isn't it, you have 6 years for a president, and some have said it's the problem we can't move forward. In the first 2 years, the president is filling out 55,000, I believe, government positions. So in the first year alone, not much is done, right?
Well, Karen, we've debated that last Congress.
Sure.
What's short and what's long? The president of the U.S. has 4 years. The president
four, so it's eight.
No. They argued that same way, but I said, how sure is the president going to get reelected? Officially and constitutionally, the term of the president is 4 years. Here it's 6 years.
But then, if you have another chance to run, I mean, that's not fair for you to not include that, because it's just 6 years. It bars you from running. You can't even run again after the term of another president. So let's say if you were, I'm just making a discussion here. I'm not pro or anti anything. Okay. So because in ASEAN, the argument is we are ranked as one of the most restrictive constitutions. You know that?
We are.
I'll give you the study. So
You're talking economics, right?
It could be just generally, but go on. Oh, okay. So
anyway, what I mentioned to them during the debate is this: the term of a prime minister or a president in some areas is 5, some is 8, some is more, some is low. I mean, a congressman has 2 years in the U.S. for one term. Here it's 3 years. So I think the issue there is term limits for them, not the extension of terms. So now you open it up to the public and you say, well, we don't want term extensions. That's it. Be frank about it. No, they're not saying that. They're just saying it's too short. What is short and what is long? Actually, there's no scientific reason for that. It's their anecdotal thing. Oh, congressman, we have a lot of work. 3 years is not enough. 6 years is not enough. But you can, doing legislative work is hard enough.
But what about the mayor? I mean, I'm just making conversation. What about the mayor? The mayor is 3 years too.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So here you are, it's operational and administrative in nature. You sit as mayor, it's new to you. You have a full year next, and by the third year, you're thinking of running again.
Yes.
So your focus is on re-election.
Yes, and going from their argument, you have 9 years to do that. I mean, you know, if you don't do it in 9 years, I was in Congress for 3 terms, and on the term, I was thinking, you know, if you really work hard, you can do a lot in 3 terms, right? It just depends. But if you sit down and just wait for, you know, for the pork, then, you know, there's nothing much you can do in 12 years or what. So for me, but, you know, the debate there, we can debate on the terms. I mean, that's, but the issue here is this. Why are we going to do a voting jointly here? And the moment they do that, Karen, they can say, well, 1 term is 10 years. I mean, nobody's giving them now. Now they can say 8 years, 6 years. The president has 2 terms, 3 terms for re-election. I mean, they have no, they can always extend or add more terms to President Marcos, right?
Okay, but I agree. But wait, I have a question here. So you have sources actually blaming the speaker as being the person behind the people's initiative, right?
Yes, we heard.
Okay,
we heard.
Okay. So you have senators. So it's 2 things. They agreed on a constituent assembly, but the people's initiative is pushing through, where it's pushing for single voting, joint voting. So in other words, it's 2 faces. That's the point. It can seem deceptive, right? Yeah. So my question is, what if the speaker says, but I can't stop the people's initiative because I have nothing to do with it? Those are private sector.
Yeah, well, actually, that's what...
Right? I mean, think of that argument. So what if the speaker comes out and said, wait, I can't stop them. That's the private sector doing the people's initiative. And right now, those facing the camera, they're the private sector.
Yes, well, actually, yes. The speaker said that he has no involvement, and so did Sigaw ng Bayan under Arroyo, and so all of them. So yeah, well, for us who are, you know, opposing it, we just allege that, of course, it's not true. But then let the people in the end decide. And in the end, you know what? The people always believe us. The people don't believe them that they're not involved, because it's the congressman, the mayor, and so on who are doing all of this. Eh? Their ward leaders are doing all of this. And an ordinary, you know, Karen, you know, as a private, an NGO, I don't think they're so well funded. Well, they can go down to the barangays, even major parties like Lakas in UCD, I don't think they can go down to the barangay level unless they use their political, you know, their congressman and their mayor and their governors. It's really possible for an NGO. Imagine how much is an ad. I mean, my estimate, they spend about 100 million in 4 to 5 days of the ad. Sino namang negosyante who will spend 100 million in 4 days for ads about EDSA Puera? So, all these things point to me that there is something behind this. But if they insist that they're not involved in it, then you continue doing it. We will continue opposing it. And we hope to win this battle one more time, because we believe that it is anti-people. This cha-cha is anti-people rather than for the benefit of the Filipino people.
Okay. Are you open to changing the charter at all?
I've mentioned always that I'm not really against a genuine constitutional reform. I'm just asking members of Congress and, you know, whoever, don't load it with your personal agenda or vested interest, and you convince us, and maybe we can support a move of genuine constitutional reform.
Okay. You also have some that want a change in the way the president and the vice president are elected. They want a tandem instead of separate voting.
For me, you know, these forms are secondary to me. Eh? I mean, if there's corruption, whether you run in tandem or not in tandem.
But they don't work together. That's the problem. That's what some said. We've experienced it too many times that you have the 2 highest people in office that don't work together, or either compete, don't cooperate.
Yeah. I mean, you know, as I mentioned, that's not a substantial issue for me. I mean, I'm not go against Chacha merely because they're proposing this or that. For me, that's very secondary. It happens in the U.S. In some countries, it does not happen. In the U.S., it's tandem. In some countries, no. So some countries are good, some countries are bad. So, yeah.
Okay. So you know what, attorney? I want to ask you the truth.
Yeah.
Is the reason why we can't change the charter in the Philippines really an issue of trust? We simply don't trust our leaders. FBR tried to change it. GMA tried to change it. All I want to ask you is who has to lead it for you to want to change it?
Yes. Well, I don't think it's merely an issue of trust, Karen. If you don't trust somebody, but that somebody actually is not doing anything wrong, the person proposing it is sincere, your mistrust will dissipate. But the problem here actually is not an issue of trust on our part that we don't trust them, but they have their own agenda. That's where the mistrust comes. So it's not to blame the people. Oh, there's no chacha because you all don't trust your leaders. No, I blame the leaders. The people don't.
So what are we saying? All the leaders that have suggested chacha in the Philippines technically have had their own agenda to perpetuate themselves in power. All.
Well, that's one, of course. The second is they have certain policies which, you know, we disagree with, you know. So, you know, it could be a combination of things. Some to perpetuate, some for, you know, whatever anti-people policy they believe in. For example, Karen, I don't agree that we sell lands to foreigners.
But I don't think that's pitched. I mean, I'll be objective because I've done this interview with so many people. Selling lands to foreigners was never a part of it, even for the pro-chacha in the lower house.
But they
that
had
was
it
never in.
Karen, they had it in their bill. It's official. I saw it. I studied all their bills. It's there. The chacha is there. Right from the start, nung panahon ni, you know.
Because what I've heard is increasing the lease.
No. I saw the bills. I can send to you the bills.
Okay.
And of course, they got away with it, this otherwise provided by law. Now they tried. But in any case, what I mean is this. If we sell lands to foreigners, I disagree with that. So I will not support it. It's not an issue for mistrust.
Yeah, but I don't think that'll pass.
I don't think so. Yeah, I don't.
No.
Yeah, I hope so. Yeah. So in any case, what I'm saying is this. The issue of trust, I'm not comfortable with that because it sort of blames the people for what's happening. It's not the people's fault to mistrust their leaders. It's the leaders' fault because they inserted things that are, corruption, so on, and there's no relation. It's for their benefit, so that's the problem there. The leaders always insert things that makes it beneficial for them rather than for the ordinary people.
Okay. Now, what's interesting with what Justice Carpio said is a people's initiative can only amend a part of the Constitution, but it cannot change fundamental principles of the Constitution. Like, for example, a term extension, a form of government. He said you need a body. And he says that has to be either a con-con or con-as. Why isn't that clear?
Well, they will debate in the first place. It's only con-con or con-as because complicated, you know, philosophical or fundamental changes has to be debated well. And it cannot be done people's initiative. The others are arguing that because it's a one word that we're changing, it's not a revision, it's a mere amendment. We argue, of course not. One word can mean a lot. Like jointly, it violates the principles of a bicameral legislature. A word like monarchy, we are a Republican state. You change one word to we are a monarchy, and that changes a lot.
So
things like this cannot be quantitative, like, oh, it's just one word, so it's all right. It's an amendment, it's not a revision. For us, the word jointly voting is a substantial amendment to the Constitution and therefore a revision and its ramifications.
Yeah. The revision of the form. The form will change, technically, the strength of the Senate. So there's a change.
Yes. So in that sense, you change the bicameral nature. The Senate separate voting for bills to be passed in the Senate and the House separately, but you have a joint voting for Constitution. That's a little absurd. So, and what's the purpose? The purpose is very clear for us, at least. The purpose of the House is that they control the entire process because the majority, they can always sum up. Even if all 24 senators say no to a proposed amendment, just 255 members of the House, not even 300 plus, just 250 or 55 of them defeats the entire Senate, defeats the entire, the 24 senators who were, well, more or less, they were also voted by 16, 18 million people. But, 255 members can, all these things. We believe, and I agree with Justice Carpio, this is a revision. And therefore, it cannot be entertained through a people's initiative. Rather, if you want, you go for a constitutional convention if you want, but not through initiative.
On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today. Bayan Muna Chairperson, Attorney Neri Colmenares. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Karen. Thank you. Good morning, Paul.